And I said, maybe it's not going to be in my lifetime because they were so set on, you have to eat meat, you have to eat animal products. They were so set on that, I said, this is not what is going to happen. But look at this, all the studies, all the science is showing to live longer, plant-based diet. All the science throughout the whole planet, all Europe, Asia, all the studies I'm going to show to you, they are not only from here, United States, they are all over the planet. And because God is giving us wisdom, more wisdom. Eat more vegetables, eat more fruit, and it's not only eat more, I'm going to show you shortly how much. And it's to have fun with what you're doing. To live longer, eat nuts and seeds. Oh, this is what God told us at the beginning. Ooh, nuts and seeds. He was not wrong, after all. Whole grains, legumes, healthy fats. We're going to define all that soon. And to live longer, eat a diet low in refined carbohydrates, sugary products, fried foods, salt. I don't think I have to explain which ones are those. Those are the ones that we enjoy the most. White bread. I remember the first time I ate whole wheat bread. I said, why is this? This tastes awful. This is heavy. I was used to the white bread. You know, that taste. If you give it to me now, I'm going to feel like I'm eating cardboard. Because I'm so used to the other flavor, the whole wheat flavor, and it's so tasty. It's so complete. And I find the other one like, dude, it doesn't have any taste. This is terrible. Plus, gives me a terrible constipation on top of everything else. Many people say, I don't have high blood pressure, why am I going to control salt? 90% of any of you here, including the children, are going to have high blood pressure. If you don't have it now, you're going to have it. Okay? And it's not necessarily because the salt, it's because the body is getting deteriorated. Each generation, the genes are getting worse. You know, evolution says with time, our genes are going to be better, stronger, more productive. Science is showing the opposite. We are going down the hill. Therefore, salt is it has so much to do with our health and control. You find salt and you say, well, I don't put salt in what I eat. But you eat crackers, you eat bread, you eat a lot of things. I'm going to show you how to read labels in such a way that you have an idea. Today I was cooking some rice with, brown rice with pigeon peas. That was the smell that was in the house when we got there. And I looked at the can, in half a cup of those pigeon peas. Do you know what pigeon peas are? No. They're a type of beans. Okay. They're very high in protein and fiber and everything, a lot of things. In half a cup, there were 400 milligrams of sodium. 400. 400, that is the milligrams for a whole meal. But only in half a cup. And I can eat half a cup easily. Therefore, we need to be aware. If I'm going to do that, then I need to cut down on something else. Because we need to keep a balance. And we're going to talk about the packages. Everything that we eat is processed. Most of you are working, and maybe all of you are working. You don't have much time to get home. to have the little things from scratch. Let me. We are going to talk about that. How can you make things easier for you? How can you make it healthier for you, for your family, and for yourself? Even if you live alone, for you, how am I going to make it really easy and healthier for my family? I love my personal engineer. Okay. Let's talk about vegetarian versus vegan. I know this is one of the questions we had. And I'm going to give you this explanation, but then I'm going to give you the rest. Vegetarian diet excludes all animal flesh. There are different types of vegetarian. There is the lacto-ovo vegetarian, includes dairy products and eggs. The lacto-vegetarian excludes eggs. And there is kind of a name that I put it separate because it's not, I don't consider it really vegetarian. It's the pescatarian that includes fish. And if you didn't know it, if you think that you're vegetarian then and you eat fish, then you're pescatarian. And then the semi-vegetarian includes fish weekly and animal flesh twice a month, at least twice a month. I don't consider those two vegetarians. And you're going to see the difference in health benefits for the ones who include animal products and the ones who don't include animal products. Vegan diet excludes all animal foods. Animal flesh, dairy products, eggs, honey is included there. Supplements, sauces, baked foods, and processed foods containing the excluded foods, such as milk. There are a lot of products that they contain milk and yogurt and cheese, then all those are excluded. Many vegan people also, because they are considering not only themselves, they are considering the animals, they also avoid clothing, accessories, and cosmetics made with animal products. Because there is a lot of abuse. And we really, you know, sometimes we are so used to, I was telling him when he went to pick me up, there was a lizard crossing the driveway. I said, oh, I think you went over the lizard. And I said, I feel responsible for the animals in the planet. You know, guess what? God made us responsible for them. And it's not, you know, I'm not going to kill a human being for an animal, but I'm going to protect them too. I'm not going to abuse them. I'm going to, for example, I don't put in the soil things that when the turtles I have in my backyard, they are walking by, that they can eat those weeds, and they get all the poison of what I'm putting in the soil. All those things God made us, we are managers of this planet. We cannot forget we are managers of this planet. And God is going to ask us, what you did for the planet, I gave you to manage, for your area, for your environment. All that is included there. Okay.
Question?
Yes.
What is the exclusion in regards to honey?
The exclusion
of honey in vegan diet.
Ah, in the vegan, the containing excluding foods.
Yeah.
The, will be the honey. Any food containing honey, vegans don't eat it. Anything containing eggs or milk or is part of. You know, for example, there are some breads. They have milk. Not all of them, but some breads and some pastries and. Some crackers, they contain milk. Some other foods, they have cereals, they have honey. All those are excluded.
So honey is considered a byproduct, just like milk is a byproduct. byproduct for cow. Honey is considered a byproduct for bees. So that's why they put it in that category.
Yes, it's included there because comes from animal products. People use kind of variation on this. Sometimes they use the honey because it has some benefits. You can mix it like with some other products to make some type of medicines and things right. like that. Exactly. And therefore, you know, I'm not going to tell any of you how are you going to eat. I'm going to give you guidance. I want to take you from where you are right now and maybe move you a notch forward, at least a notch. Because I remember when I started as vegetarian, I didn't start eating a whole plate of broccoli the next day. For sure, I didn't. But gradually, I was adding things. I was gradually adding things and excluding others, excluding gradually. And I learned how to do that, and that is what I want you to learn here. Okay. The Adventist Health Study 2 had 96, or still, because still going, that study, and part of that study started about 15 years ago. 96,000 participants. The more plant-based the diet, the greater the benefit for conditions like those. More closer to plant-based, farther from animal products, better is the more benefits to have. And that all of them is significant the difference. Even for lacto-ovo vegetarians. And vegans, the difference is significant. Therefore, farther you are from the animal products, closer you are from better health. For example, body weight, blood cholesterol, insulin. Many people don't know that they have high insulin levels. Usually the doctors check the glucose, the sugar, the blood sugar, but they don't check the insulin level. I always tell people, ask your doctor to order insulin level. Why? Because your blood sugar could be wonderful. Some people say, oh, everybody in my family has diabetes, but my blood sugar is really good. I said, have you checked your insulin level? Maybe your blood sugar is good because your insulin level is high. Okay? What happens when the insulin level is high? The insulin, one of the things that the insulin does is they stimulate the production of tissues, the reproduction of cells quickly. Therefore, it's related to cancer. High insulin levels are related to cancer. Okay, that is the reason that is so important to keep those insulin levels as low as possible. Not only the glucose, the insulin. I remember years ago, I found a relationship between diabetic people and cancer. It was a high incidence. I said, why? Well, the high incidence was that. They had higher insulin levels, and you may be thinking, but what they had high was the glucose. No, they had high insulin levels because they were receiving injections of insulin. Because the insulin that their body was producing, their body was not using it because they had too much fat in this abdominal area, the visceral fat. Therefore, they needed to produce more insulin, more insulin, more insulin, and the blood sugar was really good. But then all that insulin was doing damage in their body. Mm-hmm. Therefore, blood pressure. Inflammation levels related to all the new conditions, to arthritis, risk of at least 11 different types of cancer. Heart disease, type 2 diabetes, kidney stones, cataracts, mortality, and a few more that I didn't have room to include there. Therefore, the plant-based diet has a lot of benefits. Healthy eating. Okay, you can see before, I remember people used to put the protein first. And people, I remember my mother thinking, okay, what I'm going to put? Okay, I have chicken, and let me see what goes with the chicken. Mm. Now it has to be the opposite. Let me see, I have spinach, and I have romaine lettuce and tomatoes. Let me see what goes with that. That goes, what goes with that that tastes good, and it's not chicken. And then we have the fruits. Those two, vegetables and fruits, they have what is called phytonutrients. Phytonutrients, there are more than 300 phytonutrients. And some people say, oh, you know, I take lycopene for my eyes, I take this other, I take vitamin A. You know what is happening? God is smarter than that. He said, I'm going to put it inside the food, and there are 70 more components in that mango that all together are the ones that are going to make the difference in your body. It's not going in with the beta carotene. If you isolate the beta-carotene, the beta-carotene doesn't do anything for you. It has to be all together. And still science doesn't know how they work, how that, the, you know, how everything operates. They still don't know, but they know that works. And in the 1990s, they found that vitamin A was really good for people with lung cancer. It was keeping the levels, the incidence of lung cancer lower for people who were eating foods containing vitamin A. And then they say, oh, wonderful. Let's go ahead and start giving them tablets. You know, people who, the smokers, let's start giving them vitamin A, the tablets. The incidence went high up. They had to stop the study immediately. So many people were dying. And they said, what happened? And they said, no. The important part here was not the vitamin A, was the beta-carotene. Beta-carotene is going to be changed to vitamin A. It's everything together, how they work together in our body. Therefore, if the food is not a supplement. Therefore, you know, those are the type of things that we need to be really aware of. Whole grains, protein, milk, we're going to talk about that, and fat. Okay. Let's watch another friend reacting to this.